सो हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू द सेशन ऑफ पीआईबी 247। मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड इन दिस सेशन गाइस एज यूजुअली वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम मोर इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द पीआईबी न्यूज विच आर रेलेवेंट फॉर ईएसआई सेक्शन ऑफ आरबीआई ग्रेड बी एंड नाबार्ड। सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन, बट बिफोर वी बिगिन इफ यू आर कमिंग हियर फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम डू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड यू हैव टू प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो जॉइन दिस टेलीग्राम ग्रुप एंड फ्रॉम हियर यू कैन रिसीव ऑल द लेटेस्ट नोटिफिकेशन रिगार्डिंग द लेटेस्ट वीडियोज एंड ऑल द information regarding the RBI SEBI NABARD courses. All right, so let's begin with the very first question, which is about the SWAMI fund. So you have to consider the following statements regarding special window for affordable and mid income housing fund, which in short is SWAMI fund, and you have to identify the incorrect statement. Now first of all, the question is why we are discussing this SWAMI fund. It was to launched in 2019, then why we are discussing it in the year 2021, there must be some news regarding this. So yes, there is a news that under this special window for affordable and mid income housing fund, the very first project has been completed, and this project is Rivali Park in Mumbai. Although this news is not important, but kyunki Swami fund news mein aaya hai to Swami fund ke bare mein hame padh lena chahiye, because Swami fund can be asked, question from Swami fund can be asked in the exam, right? This news is not important, but since it appears in the news, Swami fund, so that is why we have to study about the Swami fund, because question can be asked from Swami fund directly. Okay, so talking about Swami fund guys, so it was announced in the year 2019 as an alternative investment fund. Now what is this alternative investment fund? So guys, these are the fund which are incorporated in India, which are incorporated or established, you can say, in India, and there are various privately pooled investors. There are privately pooled investor, this is basically a privately pooled investment, जिसमें बहुत सारे private investment investors होते हैं, and the money is invested in some kind of policy for the betterment of interest of the shareholders. Okay, so basically क्या है ये एक ऐसा investment है, ये एक ऐसी fund है basically that is incorporated in India, and it consists of privately pooled investment, and that particular investment is invested into some policy, or you can say some scheme, for the betterment of interest of the shareholders of the investors. Okay, and this was announced to revive affordable and middle income housing projects across the country. So already middle income housing projects chal rahe the, unko revive karne ke liye this fund was announced, Swami fund, and its initial corpus guys was 25,000 crore. 25,000 crore ki iski initial corpus thi, and out of this 25,000 crores, 10,000 crores was contributed by the government, and the rest 15,000 crores from SBI and LIC. And what was the ratio? It was not told by the government. And who is the fund manager? Which company is the fund manager? It's SBI Cap Ventures Limited is the fund manager of Swami Fund. And the eligible projects, guys, are those all the affordable and middle income housing projects that are net worth positive, registered with RERA, Real Estate Regulatory Authority, and not been deemed liquidation worthy. उसकी liquidation की जो process है वो start ना हुई हो, या उसकी जो worth है वो liquidation वाली ना हो गई हो, right? And what is the funding procedure? So the money guys is provided in the escrow accounts that can be used only for the completion of identified projects. Now can you tell me what is an escrow account? So if you are preparing for RBI grade B, you must know this answer, escrow account kya hote hain. Aur agar aapko nahi pata hai, then there is no issue, you can write down in the comments ki okay, I don't know, then I'll tell you the answer. Okay, so you have to tell me the answer of what is an escrow account. All right, so guys, this was about this news, and now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the incorrect statements. It was announced in 2015 along with PM Awas Yojana Urban. No, it was announced in 2019, which means this statement is incorrect. Its initial corpus was rupees 50,000 crores. No, that was 25,000 crores, half of 50,000 crores. And it is an alternative investment fund. This is absolutely correct. It is an alternative investment fund managed by SBI Cap Ventures Limited. So we have to identify the incorrect statement. So therefore guys, the correct answer should be what, option A, only 1 and 2, because first two statements are absolutely incorrect. And now let's move ahead to question number 2, which is about a index. And iske baad bhi aaj hame reports padhni hai dost. So today, in today's session, we have an index and 2 reports. Okay, so you have to consider the following statements regarding inclusive internet index 2021, and you have to identify the correct statement. Now most of you will say that okay, this was the old report, why are you taking it now? Because guys, ये अप्रैल के मंथ में स्किप हो गया था, तो मिस्टेक्स है, सो अब हम इसको पढ़ लेते हैं, नो इश्यूज, आज पढ़ो चाहे कल पढ़ो, बात एक ही है। तो इंक्लूसिव इंटरनेट इंडेक्स 2021 के बारे में करंट स्टेटमेंट बतानी है। सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस इंडेक्स। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, विच ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हैज रिलीज दिस इंडेक्स? सो इट्स इकोनॉमिस्ट इंटेलिजेंस यूनिट, एंड रिमेंबर दिस रिपोर्ट हैज बीन रिलीज बाय दिस EIU इन एसोसिएशन विद फेसबुक। फेसबुक के साथ मिलके इस इंडेक्स को रिलीज किया है इकोनॉमिस्ट इंटेलिजेंस यूनिट ने, एंड रिमेंबर इट इज हेडक्वार्टर्ड इन लंडन, एंड एवरी ईयर दे ऑल्सो रिलीज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इंडेक्स, दैट इज वी ऑल नो डेमोक्रेसी इंडेक्स। डेमोक्रेसी इंडेक्स भी EIU निकालता है, हेडक्वार्टर्ड इन लंडन। एंड नाउ व्हाई दिस रिपोर्ट, ये रिपोर्ट क्या बताता है हमें? सो दिस रिपोर्ट गाइज रैंक्स कंट्रीज बेस्ड ऑन द इंटरनेट अवेलेबिलिटी, इंटरनेट अफोर्डेबिलिटी, इंटरनेट का रेलेवेंस, एंड वॉट इज द रेडीनेस ऑफ पीपल टू यूज द इंटरनेट। सो दीज आर द फोर पैरामीटर्स ऑन विच दिस रिपोर्ट इज बेस्ड। एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट द हाईलाइट, टोटल कंट्रीज आर हाउ मच, हाउ मेनी, 120, 120 कंट्रीज का टोटल इसमें इंडेक्स में इंक्लूड किया गया था। एंड दीज आर द फोर पैरामीटर्स एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड, द अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ इंटरनेट, इट्स अफोर्डेबिलिटी, इट्स रेलेवेंस, एंड द रेडीनेस ऑफ द पीपल टू यूज द इंटरनेट। ओके, एंड द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ एनी इंडेक्स इज द रैंकिंग्स। सो द टॉप थ्री कंट्रीज आर स्वीडन, USA एंड स्पेन। नंबर वन पे इट्स स्वीडन, नंबर टू पे USA, नंबर थ्री पे इट्स स्पेन। इंडिया रैंक इज 49, इंडिया की रैंक कितनी है? 49, यू मस्ट रिमेंबर इंडिया रैंक एंड द टॉप थ्री कंट्रीज। एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट द इंडिविजुअल रैंकिंग इन द फोर पैरामीटर्स, सो 77th पोजिशन इन अवेलेबिलिटी, 20th इन अफोर्डेबिलिटी, 49th इन रेलेवेंस, एंड 29th इन रेडीनेस। इसका मतलब यह है कि इंडिया के अंदर जो इंटरनेट है वो काफी सस्ता है, काफी चीप है, राइट? एंड इंडिया इज सेट टू रीच 1 बिलियन इंटरनेट यूजर्स बाय द ईयर 2025 अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस इंडेक्स। सो दिस वॉज अबाउट दिस इंडेक्स, एंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन। यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट। द टॉप थ्री कंट्रीज आर USA, जापान एंड फ्रांस। नो, दैट्स इनकरेक्ट, दैट इज इनकरेक्ट। द टॉप कंट्री is Sweden, number one page Sweden, number two page USA, right? The report has been released by World Economic Forum. So is that so? It has been released by World Economic Forum? No, it's Economist Intelligence Unit, which means this statement is incorrect. And the report is based on five parameters. No guys, there are four parameters. Okay, चार parameters है इसमें, कौन कौन से चार parameters है वो अभी हमने discuss किया था, okay? So you have to identify the correct statement. So therefore the correct answer should be what? None is correct, option D. And now let's move ahead to question number 3, which is again based on a report. Consider the following statement regarding world economic situation and prospects, media report of United Nations, and identify the correct statement. So remember, this is the media report. Before this report was launched in the month of January this year, 2021. January mein launch ho chuka hai. Ye media report hai about the world economic situation and prospects. Let's talk about this. So United Nations, remember, has revised the India's GDP growth projection, or you can say जो उसका forecast है उसको revise कर दिया है. So UN has increased India's GDP forecast to 7.5%. Earlier it has forecasted the 7.3%. In the January 2021 edition, the GDP forecasted was 73%. GDP growth forecasted was 73%. Now there is a 0.2% increase, and it has now forecasted that India's GDP will grow by 7.5% in this calendar year. And remember, this report talks about only the calendar year, not the financial year. Okay, they are talking about the calendar year, that is from January to December 2021. All right. While in 2022, and again this is the calendar year, which means starting from January 2022 to December 2022, India's GDP growth will be 10.1%, and India will be one of the fastest growing major economies of the world. Okay, and abhi ke liye, currently India's growth outlook is highly fragile due to COVID-19, because we all know ki hamare desh ki halat is samay kya hai, what is the current situation that is going on in our country. India's investment growth fell to 10.2% in this year 2021. Investment growth mein kami aayi hai, kitna ho gaya hai? 10.2% ho gaya hai. And talking about the global economy, ग्लोबल इकोनॉमी की भी ये बात करता है रिपोर्ट। सो दिस से द रिपोर्ट सेज दैट द ग्लोबल इकोनॉमी इज प्रोजेक्टेड टू एक्सपैंड बाय 5.4% इन द कैलेंडर ईयर ऑफ 2021, व्हाइल देयर वाज अ शार्प कंट्रैक्शन इन द ईयर 2020 ऑफ 3.6%। 3.6% का कॉन्ट्रैक्शन था इन द ईयर 2020, व्हाइल इन द 2021 कैलेंडर ईयर द वर्ल्ड विल ग्रो बाय 5.4%। While talking about South Asia's economic growth, so it is projected at 6.9% in this calendar year 2021, against a drop of 5.6% in the year 2020, that was the previous year, right? So that is it. इसमें हमें इतना ही पढ़ना है, बहुत ही लंबी चौड़ी रिपोर्ट है. It is very comprehensive report, which is not important for us. These are only the important things, important information which are relevant for the exams, right? So now let's come to the question. You have to identify the correct statement. The report forecasted India's GDP growth to 7.5% in 2021. Absolutely correct. The global economy is projected to expand by 5.4% in 2021. Again, absolutely correct. And in 2022, India will be the fastest growing major economies of the world with GDP growth of 10.1%. So this is also correct, guys, which means all are correct, should be the correct answer, option E, because we have to identify the correct statements. And अब आ जाओ अगले क्वेश्चन पे. क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 है, दैट इज द लास्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर टुडे. एंड नाउ यू हैव टू कंसीडर सम स्टेटमेंट्स अगेन रिगार्डिंग द रिपोर्ट ऑन पावर जनरेशन. सो देयर इज अ रिपोर्ट ऑन पावर जनरेशन दैट इज रिलीज बाय काउंसिल ऑन एनर्जी एनवायरमेंट एंड वाटर सेंटर फॉर एनर्जी फाइनेंस. एंड हियर यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. रिमेंबर गाइस, दिस काउंसिल ऑन एनर्जी एनवायरमेंट एंड वाटर, इट इज अ दिल्ली बेस्ड, न्यू दिल्ली बेस्ड थिंक टैंक. दिस इज जस्ट अ थिंक टैंक एंड दे बेसिकली वर्क टूवर्ड्स, as the name suggests, energy, environment and water, right? So they have released their market handbook for the year, for the financial year 2020-21, and there are some data regarding the power generation and the renewable energy in this market handbook. Let's talk about this data. So India's total power generation was increased by 1.3% in financial year 2021. India ka jo power generation capacity hai, that has been increased by 1% despite of COVID-19, despite of restrictions due to lockdown. So that is a very good news for all of us. Government is working towards energy generation, towards the power sector. Jo power sector hai, usme government kaafi acche se kaam kar rahi hai aaj ki date mein. India produced 12.1 gigawatt power generation capacity in the financial year 2020-21. 12.1 gigawatt ka power generation capacity tha hamara pichle financial year mein. And out of this, remember, this is very important thing. Out of this 12.1, 64% was from the renewable energy, and that is a commendable job by the government of India. अब गवर्नमेंट जो है वो रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी पे फोकस कर रही है बहुत ज्यादा. सो ये काफी ज्यादा अच्छी बात है कि 12.1 गीगावाट जो पिछले साल की हमारी प्रोडक्शन कैपेसिटी ओवरऑल पावर की थी, उसमें 64% जो था दैट वाज फ्रॉम द रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी. दैट मींस वी आर हेडिंग टुवर्ड्स द रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी एंड वी आर मेकिंग जुडिशियल यूजेस ऑफ द फॉसिल फ्यूल्स, राइट? एंड द शेयर ऑफ रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी इन द ओवरऑल एनर्जी सेक्टर वॉज 10.1%. While in renewable energy, solar energy accounted for 73% of capacity added in the financial year 2021. So we all know, guys, हमेशा solar energy का जो percentage है वो हमेशा सबसे ज्यादा होगा, because water से, wind से and जो geothermal energy होती है उससे जो energy harness करना है, that is quite difficult. Okay. So this was about this report and now let's come back to the question. Incorrect statement identify करना है. India produced 14.1 gigawatt power generation capacity. That is not 14.1, that is 12.1 gigawatt. Okay. India's total power generation was increased by 1.3%, absolutely correct. And the share of renewable energy in the overall energy sector was 12.1%. That is not 12.1, that is 10.1%. Okay. So third statement is also incorrect and we have to identify the incorrect statement. Alright, so option B will be the correct answer, only 1 and 3. Okay. And guys, that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Milte hain Wednesday ke session mein. Till then, ghar pe raho, safe raho aur padhte raho. Goodbye, take care and God bless.